Good morning. Good morning, Sister Yolanda.
Good morning. Good morning, Jessica.
Good morning. We'll be getting started in about 30 seconds. Good morning, Sister Daniela.
And Tone. Tracy, good morning, Sister Tracy. Thank you all for joining us this morning. Good morning, LaBrenda.
Good morning. Hello. Well, we're going to get started in about 15 seconds. That's just enough time for
hey,
you
Daniela.
To share and invite. We have actually two different live streams going on simultaneously. So to all of our Periscope viewers, hello, how are you? And to our Facebook Live viewers, hello, and how are you? And welcome to our Friday morning prayer.
Sorry for the moving around.
And encouragement. This morning, I want to encourage you from maybe a different perspective. Sometimes life has a tendency to change our mindsets and our positions based on what we're facing. But today I want to talk to you about the need for us to remain thankful. And sometimes it's really, really hard to be thankful when there may be things going on in your life that make you feel like it should be better. God, how did I get to this place? What do I have to be thankful about? But this is what First Thessalonians says, that we are to give thanks in all things. Now, it's interesting that Paul would have to tell us to do that because he must have realized that sometimes it's real hard to give thanks. It's real hard to say thank you, Jesus, in the middle of just getting a bad report, information that you don't necessarily like. You may have gotten some news from the doctor or a family member. It's real hard. However, what helps you become thankful from a position point of view and not just something that comes out of your mouth is knowing who you are in God and knowing that He has your back. Listen, the Bible says this, that no weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper, and every tongue that rises up against it shall be condemned. Now, I want you to know this. When the Bible says no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper, you must understand that the weapon is going to form. The weapon is going to present itself in a way that it looks like it may take you out. So that's why you continue when the Bible says, I die daily, and salvation is a consistent process. There's things that you will face on a day-to-day basis, and trust me, it will form and it will position itself to you, and it can become your distraction. But when you realize and you have the revelation that no matter what this weapon looks like, it's not going to win, it allows you to remain thankful. Do you realize that being thankful is a commandment that God has given us? So what Satan will do is he will send us things that causes us to complain and murmur. Do you know that that's the exact opposite of what Thanksgiving is all about? The Bible talks about the children of Israel, and what caused them to miss the promised land ultimately was their inability to remain thankful through the process. Listen, don't be like the children of Israel, where there were millions of people that came out of Egypt. Millions. But because they were not thankful and they found themselves always complaining and murmuring, not one of those people entered into the promised land. See, when you change your perspective of what thankfulness is, it causes you now to have a different approach, a different tenacity to say, God, you know what? In all things, I'm going to give you thanks. I'm not going to give you thanks, God, just when I'm feeling good, just when my bank account looks great, just when everything is going right. I'm not going to only give you thanks then, but I'm going to give you thanks in all things. So, beloved, listen. Make a decision today. that you're going to give God thanks no matter what. And see, what's amazing is when you decide to do that, God has a way of working it out on your behalf. And it's so interesting that in his system, thankfulness is a seed. When you continue to sow thankfulness, the harvest is going to be blessings bountifully, blessings more abundantly, restoration in your home, finances in your bank account, healing in your body just by sowing thanks. Because remember this, you're only doing one of two things as I close this morning. One of two things all the time. The Bible says as long as the earth remaineth, there's seed time and harvest. So either you're sowing seed or you're reaping a harvest. My brothers and sisters, make a decision to be thankful and to sow thankfulness throughout this weekend and watch God do what only he can do, and that's to bless your socks off. Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you. For this is the day, God, that you made, and we're rejoicing and we're glad in it. We thank you, God, for reminding us of what you commanded us to do, and that's just to be thankful. Father, we don't want to be a people that's murmuring and complaining and finding every reason not to thank you. But God, we're going to make a decision starting today to have a position of thankfulness. Not just something that's coming from the fruit of our lips, but our position in you will show you that we're thankful. Thank you, God, so much for sending your only begotten Son to die on our behalf. How dare we find ourselves complaining about day-to-day operations when we know that we were on our way to hell without your efficacious grace, without you extending your love past our sinful nature. Father, we thank you for it now. God, I thank you that this particular encouragement will continue to be rehearsed in our minds as we go through the day. Because as we have opportunities to maybe complain or to murmur, we're making the decision to be thankful. And Father, as we sow the seed of thankfulness, we're going to reap the harvest that's going to be bountiful, and the harvest that's going to cause us to walk in the abundant life that you've given to us. Father, we thank you for it now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Listen, we are so excited as we're approaching our anniversary weekend. Abundant Life Worship Center, the Lord has allowed us to reach our two-year mark, and we're going into year number three. If you're anywhere close in the Atlanta area, we want to invite you out this Sunday, where we'll have two services, 10:30 a.m. and 3 o'clock p.m. It's going down. We're going to be celebrating the name of the Lord. And the Bible says, if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men. We want you to be there because it's going to be sheer pandemonium, and it's going to be a mountaintop experience. If you want to know more about the ministry, conveniently from your phone, you can text 55469-LIFE. And anything you want to know about the ministry, if you're feeling led to donate, you're able to do it right from your phone as well. God bless you. On behalf of my wonderful wife, First Lady, myself, and the entire Abundant Life Worship Center family, we want you to know that as a believer, abundant life belongs to you.
Amen.
Goodbye. God bless you all.